This illustration will describe about analyzing polar trajectory of a boat. Here the situation is saying that the figure shows a boat starting from point A on one bank of the river in such a way that its velocity always heads toward point B on opposite bank of river. And if current speed is n times the boat speed with respect to water and river width is d, we are going to find the trajectory of boat in polar form as r is equals to f theta. Here we take the position of boat is at a distance r from point B. So here we are going to find r as a function of theta for the boat, which is termed as polar trajectory. Here in the solution, we can first redraw the picture for its in-depth analysis. Say if these two points are A and B and the boat is moving in such a way that its velocity V is always heading toward point B. In this velocity, the current velocity is added, which is NV. That will give a velocity of boat with respect to ground, which is along the tangential direction of the trajectory in which the boat is moving. This is the position of boat. So here, if this angle is theta, here if we draw the transverse direction, which is normal to the position vector of boat, this angle would also be theta. And here this angle would also be theta if this is the line parallel to line AB. So here we can say we analyze the motion of boat. We analyze the motion of boat along radial and transverse direction. So in this situation, if we calculate the radial velocity of boat as it is heading towards point B, which we are taking the origin of our system as we wish to calculate r as a function of theta. Here radial velocity we can write as minus dr by dt, and this can be written as v is the speed with which it is heading toward point B, and nv sin theta is the speed with which it is moving away from B. So this can be written as minus dr by dt is equals to v minus nv sin theta. And the transverse velocity v theta, that is along the line perpendicular to the position vector, we can write it as r d theta by dt, and this is equals to only nv cos theta. So if these are equations 1 and 2 for us, here we can divide the two equations, and you can see giving 1 by 2, this will result as dr by r d theta, and this is equals to, we can take this negative sign on the other side, so it is nv sin theta minus v upon nv cos theta, which will further give us tan theta minus 1 by n sec theta. We further simplify this, it will result dr by r is equals to tan theta minus 1 by n sec theta multiplied by d theta. If we integrate this expression, we'll get r as a function of theta, and we can see when theta was 0, the value of r was d, which was the width of this river, and at an angle theta, the position of r is r. So integrating left hand side will result as ln of r, and we apply limits from d to r. On right hand side, when we integrate, the integration of tan theta is minus ln of cos theta minus 1 by n ln of the sec theta plus tan theta, which is the integration of sec theta, and we apply limits from 0 to theta. And further, if we continue from here, left hand side, this will be ln r minus ln d. So this will give us ln of r by d is equals to, on right hand side, this will give us ln of, if we just take here, this can be written as ln of sec theta minus 1 by n ln of sec theta plus tan theta. So this 1 by n we can take over the power of sec theta plus tan theta. So this will be ln of sec theta divided by sec theta plus tan theta whole power 1 by n. And if we take anti-log on both sides, we are getting the value of r, which is d sec theta divided by sec theta plus tan theta to whole power 1 by n. So, this will be the final result of this problem. The polar trajectory of boat by in the river current by treating point B as origin of this coordinate system.